Today we are going to discuss about the turnover ratios. So the turnover ratios is nothing but to show the efficiency of the assets or other items that have been used to generate revenue from operations. So how the assets are being used to generate sales, to generate an income. When you do sales, obviously it brings you an income back. So how the assets are used in the process of sales to get that income is what this turnover ratio is going to show us. So there are four types of turnover ratio, that is inventory turnover ratio, trade receivable turnover ratio, trade payable turnover ratio, and fixed asset turnover ratio. So first let's see what is inventory turnover ratio. Inventory, in the sense, inventory is stock. So how stock is being used to generate sales, that is going to be calculated in the inventory turnover ratio. So the formula for inventory turnover ratio is cost of revenue from operations, that is nothing but your sales, divided by average inventory. So average, in the sense, always stock will be opening stock and closing stock, so you must take the average out of it. So average inventory is equals to opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2. Next, cost of revenue from operations. So cost of revenue from operations can be calculated in two different formulas, that is purchase plus change in inventories of finished goods plus direct expenses. Or when revenue from operation is given the sum, you can use revenue from operation minus gross profit to get the cost of revenue from operation. Cost of revenue from operation is one of the most important formulas to be learned in ratio analysis. Next, moving on to the next ratio, we have trade receivable turnover ratio. So trade receivable turnover ratio is a ratio which is for credit sales. So when we do credit sales, we have to collect the money from our debtor, from the person to whom we have sold it in credit. So this ratio is a comparison between the credit sales and the average amount of receivables, that is average amount of amount received from those debtors during an accounting period. So the formula for trade receivable turnover ratio is credit revenue from operations, that is your credit sales, divided by average trade receivables. Now average trade receivables, again it has opening trade receivables and closing trade receivables. Likewise, it has opening bills receivables and closing bills receivable. So when we are dealing with debtors over here, bills receivable, that is a bill of exchange, comes into the scene. So average trade receivable, here the formula is given only for opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divided by 2. And trade receivables is given as trade debtors plus bills receivable. Trade payables turnover ratio. So this ratio shows the comparison between net credit purchase with the average trade payable, that is how much we have purchased in credit and how much we have to pay back to our creditors will be shown in the trade payables ratio. So the formula for the trade payables ratio is net credit purchases divided by average trade payables. So here net credit purchases mean total credit purchase minus the purchase return. Likewise, how we do for average trade receivable, the same here, but it is trade payables. Therefore, we will have opening trade payables plus closing trade payables, whereas trade payables is equals to trade creditors plus bills payable. Whereas in trade receivables, it was trade debtors plus bills receivable. Here it will be creditors and payables. Likewise, how we did for trade receivable, the debt collection period, here we must show the credit payment period. So the if it is in days, you must do number of days divided by the answer what you get for trade payable turnover ratio. If it is payment in months, it will be number of months in a year by the answer, that is trade payable turnover ratio. Next is the fixed asset turnover ratio. So this ratio shows how the assets have been utilized in creating revenue or in creating the income for the year. So the formula for the fixed asset turnover ratio is revenue from operation, that is the sales, divided by average fixed assets. So average fixed assets include opening assets plus closing fixed asset divided by 2.